मॉर्निंग वी हैव कॉपीड टू फाइल्स, वन इज लिस्ना डॉट ओरा एंड द अदर वन वॉज टी एन एफ नेम डॉट ओरा. यू कैन चेक इट बाई गिविंग द एल एस कमांड. ओके, दिस नाउ दिस फाइल आई हैव टू कॉन्फिगर टी एन एफ नेम्स डॉट ओरा फॉर क्लाइंट साइड. Again, some built-in means already some lines are there which I don't require. I will just press escape and DD. I will remove it. Or you can keep this as it is, and at the end you can type. But it is some case sensitive. In morning you saw that even if that line blank line was there at the end, he was showing error. So case sensitive, remove all the things and type our own lines there. So now here we have to give the alias name first. There I have used ABC.
No, XYZ.
At the end XYZ. Yes. Okay. Now here some different word we will be using here. Okay. For example, definition or DEF, whatever we require the name, you use it. Again. In capital you type on description equal to same letter, my number 192.168.1.10. That same IP address now in client side.
Yes.
That my server IP address has to be. It should not change. Port equal to I think 5122 we have used there.
1522.
I told you that from that series also you can use the port number. So you can use any port number in between that series. Okay. Blank line I was telling in that file, no? At the end it blank line was there. Okay, finish. Now how to check this file? TNS ping.
TNS ping.
And that alias name. Thank you. number from there. Listen, until we don't restart the network, my client will not connect. No? That's why, because at the time of shutdown, the network also closed down. So I have not started my network till now. No? So my database, my network is not on. How can my client can ping to my that particular? Cannot resolve name that. No? First, I have to start that network. XYZ. LSN RCTL start XYZ. First, already been started. Just try to close it. RCTL start XYZ. Now, what I will do? Maybe this terminal it is. Cat command to see the description, inside description. Equal sign we have to insert that after DEF now. Equal sign.
See, the concept of database links is what? This is your database called DB. Okay. Now I'm having one more database on my server. That is, suppose is school DB. You are having some tables in call DB. Okay. Suppose what we have created EMP. The other table is DEPT, and I am having two tables in this school database also, salary and suppose attendance, like this. So if database is same, in same database these two tables are there, no problem of giving the rights from one table to another table. You can easily give the rights from one user to another user. Suppose this is in U1 and this is in U2. Okay, these are my two users. So easily I can give the grant command between this particular database. But you can't give the grant. This is my U3 user and this is my U4 user. You can't grant U2 to U3. Yeah. So for this purpose, you require a database link. Means you have to create one link to connect between two databases. Then only with the help of that link you can move to this particular user of another database. From here to here you can link. That is the main concept of database link. Now when database link will work? When your listener and TNS are configured, because network concept is this. Because one on one particular server this database, on another server this database. Now I need to connect two servers. So listener should be there, one should be TNS. Then only I can connect, na? That's why that first topic was compulsory for this chapter. Okay. So just have a look how, see, to create links between two database and two users, or two users also. Okay, and of that database is known as database links. Condition: Oracle networking should be start. For this, your listener should be there and TNS ping, that client should be ping with your server. Only this concept. And one more, the topic is materialized views. Materialized views, as we have seen views in SQL, it is a mask over a table. When you enter something in a base table, the records goes to your views automatically. If you insert the records, update the records, delete the records in a table, effects is done automatically to my views. You remember, no? Views in SQL, that concept. Same way this materialized views are there. Means you can move your data from one user to another user, one database to another user, like that you can create. What? To restrict user of client side. Why I am creating materialized views? To restrict user of client side. If listener down, that then database link disconnected. Obviously. Yes? No security. For this we will use materialized views. If you want to give your table to another user, so what you will be doing, you will not giving your original table, you are creating a view and giving him. But here normal view will not work, that SQL views will not work in this DBA. Here materialized views are there. This views are known as materialized views in DBA, in SQL views. So see, materialized view will occupy space in storage. Normal view not store. That SQL normal view not store, but he will store. So this is a disadvantage, you can say, materialized views. So nowadays in database administrator on server, we are not creating materialized views. Means we are just granting the permission and allowing them to use the table, because he can't do anything, na? If I grant something, only those commands will run. That's why we are not creating materialized views. To create materialized view, one privilege required to user. Create materialized view. This privilege should be there with that user. Now, data is refreshed, one background process is there. Data is refreshed, okay, but not like normal views. As soon as you insert, it takes the effect. It shows directly. No need of manually making refresh or reload the data to see the current information in views. automatically it does in normal view. But here one background process is there, it refresh data server to client. When see tables are there on server as well as materialized views are created on server only, just user using views instead of table, there's the difference. But views are not refreshed, one background process data, one background process is there for refreshing this data, that is CJQ, as we have learned about MMON, PMON, SMON, process monitor, system monitor, same way one background process is there, okay. But in this refresh there is technology, it depends on you how to refresh, okay. Refresh technology depends on two modes, one is commit and other one is on demand. Commit means it will work on local database and on demand will work on remote, these two. And refreshing types are there, how you want to refresh, that is complete. It will degrade client performance if you are using refreshing type as a complete, means again and again I have to give commit and performance will go down, na? Like that fast, this will not degrade and it is a fast refreshing technology. Note, for this primary key required on master table, materialized views, logs. Instead of complete, if you are using a refreshing type fast, then he is telling that if your table should have a primary key, then only you can use this refreshing type fast. Yeah, complete without. And fourth, combination of complete and fast, if primary key, not master table. Okay?
There is no primary key.
Also, fourth. So how to create? Create a materialized view, view name, see refresh and the type of that. Complete, fast or fourth, you can type here. Start with from where you want to start adding your records to your materialized view. So I'm start with next sys date plus 1, each minute I am counting, after each minute my server should refresh my materialized view, that 24 by the calculation, as select star from which table, for this table I am creating a materialized view course, at the rate db link 1, that is my database link above, as alias name we were using, now database link we have to create. Okay, note, whenever we use fast refresh type, for that we have to create one log file to see the newly added records. See, create materialized view log on here, one more example is there, means you understood the concept, but about database link, I have to create one link, then only I can create a materialized view. Just we will try whether it is working or not, otherwise we will go to next topic then. Just I will show you. Fresh new user we will create. Resource A, I am creating by A, one user. Now grant, normal user I have created that A. Okay. Now grant connect comma resource comma this rights I have to give if you want to create that link. You will decide, na? User will decide whether I want to allow them to connect or not. So I will create one link first, then only I will provide the views and issuing them the rights, like that. So this create database link should be there. Then create public database link. Two types of links are there, one is private, other one is public. Create database link, create public database link, so both I am giving him. So first one is private and the second one is public link. So you know the difference between private and public, na? Private means just for that user. Public means for all users, you can say. If you are creating as a public, okay, then create materialize MTRA huh? And the materialize view 2, the username I am deciding here B, password identified by B. So at the time of user creation only I can grant all the things like this. This is a shortcut method, na? Means all the sessions, all the things have been provided. Okay, now we will just check one parameter, that is global names. Okay, this should be false. This parameter should be false for the above database link. So it is false, no need of changing it. If it is true, suppose if it is true, change it. How to change it? Alter system set global names equal to false, like this. So it is false, I will delete this command. Okay, so any parameter value you want to change from SQL, this is the syntax. Alter system, that parameter name, that is undo TBS equal to manual I want to do. So undo TBS equal to manual I can type here. So auto to manual. No need of going to parameter file again and all the things. Just to change the value, not to add the parameter. For adding a parameter, that shut down, then move to parameter, again restart the database. But value can be changed with the help of SQL prompt. Clear? Okay. Now just I will move to this B user, and we will try that link is create database link. Okay, I am keeping the link name DB link. Using this link, which user we want to allow, so you have to specify that. Connect to A, his password you should know, identified using what, that alias name client side configuration. I have used this word in client side, na? DEF. How can I create a link? How can I? This private. I am not using the word public here. But we have to check. Okay. Yeah, this error is correct. But after that you should not give any error, because the DEF is configured, na? He should take, because that ping is okay now, so he should take. Just I will check if that listener is not started and my TNS is not ping, then this command is not possible, because the DEF actual alias name I am using, and first it should configure, then only I can use that name, na? This name is not like a simple word. This we have used in the TNS name.ora. This name, database link created, because it was ping, na? That's fine. Okay, no problem, na? Practically also it is clear now. Yeah, now see in which user I am right now. Yeah, but I can operate A now. All the things I can see of A user now. Connectivity between user. Okay, how? See, select star from tab. But if I give here now tab @db link, so he will show me A user tables. Why I have created this link? To connect to A.
Oh, now how much will
insert? You don't have to go to A to operate that table. You will remain in your user, and you will operate A user from here. with the help of this link.
Oh, yes.
You can go to from one user to another user to operate that user.
Why submit?
Yeah, yeah.
Submit.
Any insert in always you have to use @dblink now.
Yes.
In insert command, update command, anything. You can create the table also from here in A. Create table, table name na. So @dblink, create table emp @dblink means he will create the table in A user. Actual LAN is there, it will work smoothly in VMware na. He is confused because already we are working in virtual that workstation and we are telling him to work in a networking also. So you can create now materialized view also in this way. I will show you how to create, but it should work. But first, so three topics were there in networking. First, configuring the listener file. Second, TNS configuration. Then how to create a database link. For creating a database link, first sys should provide the rights to that user. Creating database link publicly or privately. Okay, as well as for creating a materialized view, sys should grant the rights to that user to create the materialized view. That's why while creating this B user, I have given that materialized view right also, so that B can create materialized view. By default, no any other user can create a database link. Instead of sys gives the rights. Yeah, yeah. B can create database link and materialized view. A cannot create like that. Just I will stop this. Control C. Or I will close this. You understood, na? That it will take some time to show, but it will show now because it is created. Okay, we are in sys now. Just I will show you how to create the materialized view. Materialized view v1. Okay, refresh. First type is complete. I start with sys date. Next sys date plus 1 each minute. We are telling him after each minute we want to refresh it. For which table? We are not having any single table, but in this, first you should have a table, no? To create a view. Now from EMP you can say @ but using dblink. Link should be there. Spelling mistake. Spelling mistake again. Refresh. So which background process will support this? CJQ. This technology is handled by one of the background process, that is CJQ. That background process name is CJQ. That link is taking time, DB, because it is moving, na?
Yes.
B2A like that. So the next topic will be control file management. It's a just 10 minutes topic. Just we have already added one control file, that is control.ctl, okay, in parameter file. But what Oracle recommends, suppose that control file itself corrupts, so you should have a one backup copy, na, of that control file. Okay, I will take a copy of that control file today. If you work tomorrow in that database, some new additions are coming to my database, so this control file will be of no use for me, because control file updates automatically, na? Each day it updates, each day or each minute you can say. If any changes are there in database, control file is updated. Means that file, that current file is important for me as compared to the last day file. So I should have more than one control file. My data should go to three places simultaneously. That is nothing but multiplexing. So how multiplexing can be done? Just with the help of control file. We should add control file more than one. Maximum 7 can be added. Recommended by Oracle, you should keep 3. But system will be slow, because each time my data is going in 3 different places. So higher configuration PC are there in companies, so there no problem. Yeah, servers and like that. Now Oracle original license copy servers like that. So there it is must. Instead of taking the risk of data, if it is slow, okay, no problem, no? Because data is going. If anyone corrupts, second I can log in with second file. If this file corrupts, I can't start my database, because we have studied. If instance is there, database is there. If instance down, if my control file is not there, means my instance down, my instance corrupted. So how can I start with my database? And if you create a new control file, your old data will go. At the time of login, the database will not configured. This database will be old and your control file will be new. He will not configure what actually he will confuse. At the last time my brain having this much, now new, I am totally new, like that. So multiplexing is best for that. So simple topic, just we have to add two files in parameter file, control 1, control 2. To do about this, this command is okay, but why it is taking time? That command is recorded, you can see that command. And it will execute, but that command will execute, no problem about that, because no error in that command, just it is slow, na? That's why it taking time. Where? This one?
No. I think there is more than sessions.
What's on this?
No.
See, for shutdown also taking too much time.